on, guys. Just headed out on the lake. It is May 11th, and we're going to go see if we can find some bass. It's been a grind. Last week was opener. Caught a few fish, but I'm going to go super shallow in this cut between lakes. I'll show you guys what that looks like on a map and stuff, and we'll see if we can find them. The water temp out here from the dock is 49, and hoping it's going to be a bit warmer in there, and we can find some pre-spawn bass. So let's get her going. It's like 1 degree warmer, but I think as we go further north up the cut, it'll get a little bit warmer than that even, so hopefully we can find some fish there. But what I was saying was, this isn't actually technically a lake. If you look around, it just looks open with a bunch of bogs, but as soon as the pads come up, this is what it shows on like the Lake Master chip, and that's pretty much what it'll be once the pads come up, just like a river practically. You just shoot between the cut, or between all the pads, and that's how you get to the next lake. But before the pads come in, there's a lot of fishable water, like 3, 4, 5, sometimes 6 feet deep. So we're gonna work that, just kinda zoom around, dodge bogs, hopefully not hit any logs or stumps, and hopefully catch some fish. So let's see what we can do. I'm up shallow looking for these fish in like 1, 2, 3 feet of water. My favorite presentation is the weightless Senko, and I normally just go with Yum Dingers, and since this water is super clear, I go with the natural watermelon red flake. So that's what we're going to be using to start us off here. Alright, I just snapped on a new polarizer lens for the GoPro I forgot I had. So, I don't know, we'll see if that makes a difference, if you guys can see in the water any better since it's so clear. But again, weightless Senko, watermelon red flake. And the water's a little over 50 now, so let's go. I just lost a nice fish and it wrapped me on that log right there. Let's go. Finally. It's a better fish too. Come here, buddy. Oh boy. Oh, let's go. Look at that. Look at that belly. Finally. I don't know if that was the same fish, but I saw him come chasing out after it off that log right here. And boom. A little butterball. Let's go. Come on, hook. Ah, there we go. Turn him into the sun. Woo! Let's go, baby. Let's go. I'm gonna snap a pic with him quick and we're gonna get a release on him. Alright, let me get this fatty back real quick. Oh, thank you, buddy. Look at that belly. Ooh, let's go.
Cool eat. Saw that guy just come flying off the wood, pause the weightless Senko for just a second, watching absolutely crush it. So definitely a good sign, super aggressive fish. So we're just going to keep getting after it and hopefully pick up some more and find some more wood. You guys can see that, but there's a muskie sitting right here. His back's all beat up. Probably take off in a second. Maybe. Yeah, there he goes.
Alright, I said we were going to go to the main lake like an hour ago, but it just looked too good not to fish. I ended up getting that one, but we're going to make it out to some bigger water now.
Yikes. I don't even know if I'm gonna make under this thing. Water's so dang high. Do a little pull procedure here. Let me make sure that, oh my goodness. Just scuffed the heck out of that. Oh, it's gonna be fun going back on the way home. Whew. All right,
what's up guys? It's the next day now. Just headed out onto the lake and it was sunny. Temps were 55 at the dock. I was thinking might actually catch some fish today, and as I'm coming out, it just starts raining, so we're sitting here under this bridge just waiting it out. There was no rain in the forecast, so I gotta think it'll pass quick. At least I hope so. Anyhow, headed back to the cut where I was yesterday, thinking the water should be close to 60. Might have some aggressive pre-spawn bass, so stay tuned.
Guy. Take that though all day. Hey, look at that. A chunker. Yeah, so before there was three kayakers coming in, right as I hooked up with that fish, they were pretty close, and I don't know, I kind of just nonchalantly fought it, which I'm a little bit upset about because I think it was actually a pretty good fish and ended up getting off, but I didn't really say anything just because of the fact that there was people coming in. Didn't want them to think I was some crazy guy just talking to myself or something, so that was that. But just saw a few more fish back there, so they're definitely in here. Water temp is like 3 degrees warmer than it was back by my dock, so fish are pushed up in here in this warm water, so hopefully we keep smoking. Oh man, I'm just seeing them cruising everywhere right now. Oh god, that's a decent one. There's like 5 of them right here. Holy shit. They're everywhere. This could be good, guys. I might just start hammering if I don't keep spooking them.
Oh my goodness. Guys, they're loaded over here.
I saw one waking, just come flying over the second mine hit the water. I set the hook a little too early. missed him. As soon as I started reeling, got another one, just smoked it. That was crazy. All right, we're going to do a little skip, see if there's one flying in. Oh, here he comes. He's waking. He's got it. Nope, he dropped it. Felt pretty small. Oh, he's coming. He's got it. Oh, these must be dinks over there. Dang it. Not the one I was trying to get to eat, but at least he ate. It's a dinker. There we go. Watched him come smoke it. Oof, look how pretty he is. Messed up fin, but hey, thanks, bud. Oh, little guy. Does he even have that? No. It's so clear and shallow, I can see these fish. They'll just come grab it, and those small ones, they'll fold the Senko in half. And the ends will just be sticking out. So it's like you can feel them running with it, but they don't actually really truly have it. Golly. These dinks are getting to me, guys. They just grab it and they just run like no other. Keep thinking I'm going to set the hook and it's going to be a big one, but every time I either rip it out or I jerk the fish out of the water, they're so small. Oh boy. That's a better fish. Ooh, he's coming up. Dang. This guy's going crazy. Oh, look at that. It's not a terrible fish. Definitely the biggest of the day by a long shot. He's got a beat up fin too, like his buddy back there. Good old watermelon, red flake Senko coming in clutch. God, he waked so hard on that. Man, this guy's beat up. Holy cow. Back. It's a decent fish right here. Oh, that's a big one behind him. Oh my goodness. There's so many right here. Oh. It's a better fish. That was a pretty fish. It's a nice lateral line. I saw this guy dive down deep. There's like a 5-foot hole right there. I was about to flip like a craw in there or something. But I let this thing start sinking super slow and I saw my line going. Boom, let's go. Release on this nice guy. Ooh, let's go. Let's go on the Giltec jig, baby. Woo-hoo. He crushed that thing. Let's go. Oh, baby. You kidding me, bud? Oh, yes. Oh, that's sick. Crushed that right at the boat. It's a good fish, too. All right, we're getting him back. Let's go. On the swim jig, baby. Shout out to Giltech. I actually won these in one of their giveaways. They make some sick jigs, so look at that. I think they're called this Structure Lock Swim Jig. And basically, they just got these super nice weed guards, and this is one of the beefiest, strongest hooks I think I've ever seen on a jig, so definitely check these guys out. They make some sick stuff. Literally just jerked a weed off that thing. I watched him inhale it. Oh my goodness. Dang. Freaking munched that thing. Oh my goodness. Alright, look at that fat pre-spawner. Just annihilated the jig. Let's go. This thing is sick. I mean, I knew it looked good coming into this. That looks way too good not to catch fish, and she's producing biggins only too. Not biggins, but nice solid Wisconsin fish for sure. Watch that thing just come and annihilate it right at the boat. Oh, just yanked little buddy over the boat. Sorry for that vicious hook set. They're loving this jig though. Wow. Beauty. Up with this, but like three or four of these fish have hit just right at the boat. All the ones I've caught, anyhow. Not a bad little chunker chunk. Thanks, buddy. Jeez. Ripped his mouth right off, too. Another good fish. They are absolutely loving this Giltech jig though. Holy crap. Whew. Nice fatty. Let's go. Ugh. Come here, buddy. Oh, he's off. That's right, it's probably only like a pound and a half or nothing huge. Decent little guy, nothing huge. Another one on the swim jig. That's a good fish. Just right in the top of the mouth. Look at that. Oh, baby. And it's just starting to rain. It's getting a little disappointed. I hadn't seen a fish in a while. Boom. Let's go. That's a big one for this lake. That is a great fish. Holy cow. I got him through those weeds and he just started digging. I didn't think he was that big at first, but whew, let's go. It's a good fish.
Alright, gonna get the release of this biggin. That's my biggest of the year. For sure.
Look at that. That swim jig is killing.
Alright guys, that's going to be a wrap for today's video. I actually just came out to kind of scout. It's Mother's Day, my mom wants to come out, but I mean, it's raining now, it's not the warmest day. And she's a big heat person, so she said if they're biting, I'll come out. So obviously, they're biting. So I'm going to go get her, hopefully this rain passes, and we'll get out and get her on some fish. So basically the key today was, the main lake was like 55, I got back in here. Most of it was 58 and the shallow parts were like 60, 61. So they're pre-spawn right now. They're all over in here. And that's where you need to go this time of year. Find them up shallow, nice and fat, getting ready to spawn. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more B&T fishing.